स्टार्ट। मिस्टर चेयरमैन सर, वेरी एमिनेंट एंड कैपेबल पीपल फ्रॉम बोथ द साइड्स हैव पार्टिसिपेटेड इन द डिबेट एंड मेड वेरी वैल्यूएबल सजेशंस। द गवर्नमेंट हैज मेड ए नोट ऑफ ऑल दोज सजेशंस एंड माई कॉलीग विल गिव ए डिटेल्ड reply to all the points that have been raised. On my part, I would like to make a few observations on this vital bill having far-reaching consequences. Almost all those who have participated in the debate expressed their faith and confidence in the democratic system which we have adopted for our country. It is a well-known fact that ever since we attained independence, democracy has been extremely successful in this country. Still, there may be some shortcomings here and there. With the amendments that are brought forward today, I do not say that everything is going to be perfect. However best something might be, there is always scope for reform and improvement. Let me say at the outset that this piece of legislation brought forward by this government is intended to strengthen this democratic system of our country from the grassroots. This bill, for the first time, addresses itself to major electoral reforms, the process of which has already been initiated by this government. It has been stated by some members that the opposition has not been taken into confidence by the government before bringing in this legislation. I do not understand what is meant by that. You are aware that there is no recognized opposition as per the rules. Despite that, I would like to say quite categorically, each group was consulted and given an opportunity to put forth its point of view. We have consulted the opposition in a very fair and objective manner, and we have gained by the views they have expressed. So far as this government is concerned, we want the opposition to grow and to develop, but I am very sorry to say that during all these years of India becoming free, no opposition party has developed with a national perspective. Speaking about the present system, it has also been said that there is government monopoly over the media. I would like to remind them that at the time of elections, equal opportunity is being given to all the recognized political parties. Guidelines have been laid down in this regard after a great deal of thought. If there are any violations, members are at liberty to raise them, and they can be rest assured that their genuine awareness of our social responsibility and out of this sense of challenge that this center of learning was born nearly 50 years ago. Its aim was to mould and fashion a new type of Indian. It is appropriate that we should take stock of the social scene of our day and also examine to what extent we have succeeded in molding the new kind of Indian. I had occasion recently to tell a gathering of scientists that there need be no conflict between the Indian man and the modern man, nor indeed the universal man. On this very holy land, thousands of years ago, our sages proclaimed that the world is one family. They taught us that change is the law of life. In our own days, a philosopher who lived and worked in this city advised and admonished us not to be prisoners of the past but pilgrims of the future. At this place, we heard a new theory of the Indian, a theory which denies Indianness to hundreds of thousands of children of India. Dear sir, we are very thankful to you for your letter of 6th instant, appreciating the services rendered by our engineer in your village. We are also happy to know that the work done as per the advice of our engineer was also recognized by the government. We saw from the local newspapers that such pattern would be examined and adopted for the needy villages all over the state. We have to congratulate you for our efforts to develop remote villages into modern villages. In your letter, you also expressed that the services of the same engineer may be spared for a couple of months more and that your project would start in the month of December in other new villages. In this connection, we have to inform you that the said engineer and his team are presently busy in Madras attending a workshop meant for developing very remote villages and hamlets of hill areas. There is no scope at all to provide any amenities in such backward hamlets and villages. There are no roads, no water and power. As such, our team has to do some ground work there and give proposals for certain schemes which are feasible, keeping in view the interests of the government to uplift the poorest and the weakest. As such, we have to inform you that it will not be possible for us to agree with your request for deputing the said team. Yours sincerely, consultant.